get it.
Yeah, y'all know what time it is. It's Learning with Queen CJ time. Let's get it. Let's get it. No more confusion. It stops now. Let's learn about these adjectives. An adjective is a word or phrase that describes a noun. It can modify a person, thing, or idea, or a place within a town. I guess that's why adjectives are modifiers, because modify means change. Adjectives change and describe a noun. Listen, and I'll explain. Adjectives give you information, like appearance, color, shape, and size. Quantity, origin, or age. Some examples I'll provide. Talented, beautiful, exciting, magnificent, calm, magenta, dizzy, African, gentle, enormous, helpful, elongated, hilarious, brilliant, splendid. First up is an attributive adjective. It's the easiest to recognize. In a sentence, it always comes before the noun that it describes. The happy family, my funny pet, a tall building, the blue skies, the furry coat, pretty dress, smart class, her green eyes. Happy, funny, tall, blue, furry, pretty, smart, green. Happy, funny, tall, blue, furry, pretty, smart, green. Now predicate adjectives are different because they appear after the noun, which usually means a linking verb is near. He is strong, she is calm. He is gentle, she is fearless. Fearless. Is this the linking verb? Strong, calm, gentle, fearless. Strong, calm, gentle, fearless. Strong, calm, gentle, fearless. Strong, calm, gentle, and fearless. Now remember, those are called predicate adjectives because they come after the noun that they describe or modify. Let's go. What are two or more equally important adjectives used to describe the same noun used with the word and or a comma in the sentence would make sense even if you switch the adjectives around? The air was thick and foggy. The puppy was brown, little, and cute. Their loud, insistent voices. Those are what we call coordinate adjectives. Let's go. Thick, foggy, brown, little, cute, loud, insistent. 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 Cumulative adjectives could be considered the opposite. They must be in a particular order for the sentence to make sense. You can't use a comma or the word and in between these adjectives because they come from different categories. One is more important than the other adjective is. Now this list is the order of categories that all cumulative adjectives must appear in. Let's go. Quantity, opinion, size, age, or condition. Length or shape, color, origin. Material and purpose, those are the last two. These are the categories cumulative adjectives fall under. So what we gonna do, we gonna learn them. Yeah, we're gonna learn it. Yeah, we're gonna learn it. We're gonna learn it. We're gonna learn it. Learn it. So adjectives come in three forms. You got absolute, comparative, and superlative. So when we think about the degrees of comparison, you gotta bring these adjectives in the mix. Don't forget, you got absolute, comparative, superlative. Let's go. Absolute adjectives describe the noun in its own entirety. Comparative adjectives make a comparison between two or more things. Superlative adjectives imply it's the best in quality. Some absolutes end in Y.
Comparative, drop the Y at E-R. Superlative at I-E-S-T. Follow that rule when the word has less than two syllables. If it has more, add more or most.
For comparative, we add more.
Hey, for superlative, we add most. Hey, just make sure you put it before the adjective. And remember, some of these rules have exceptions. For example, handsome has two syllables, but you wouldn't say handsomer. So beautiful has three syllables, but you would say the most beautiful. So remember, there are exceptions to these rules. Read up on it. Make sure you're right. So guess what? There are more types of adjectives. Yep. Let's see. We got demonstrative, descriptive, distributive, indefinite, interrogative, possessive, proper, quantitative, and sequence adjectives. So check them out.